Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecam.net and welcome back to another Copycat Friday! Do you guys remember when I was in love with an LG monitor? Well, move over old love, I have a new love. This 38-inch ultra-wide monitor from LG. Look how pretty it is! And big. Wait, I'll... Ta-da! Pretty. Anyways, we're not here to talk about my love life. We're here for some Zach King editing magic. So let's start and fire up Premiere Pro. Now the first effect we are going to recreate is pouring the liquid from our new LG Ultra Wide monitor, or any other monitor you have, doesn't matter. Like you can see in my project panel, I already have my footage in there. But what footage do we need? Well, that's a good question, and let's have a closer look.
Whoa! Watch it, Lorenzo! All right, now that you're here, guys, this effect is actually super easy. The only thing that you have to do is take a bottle with some orange juice inside, and we're going to stick that to the back of the monitor. Now, you want to stick that orange juice a little bit slanted, but make sure that the juice is not coming out. All right, we can now go ahead and take off the cap from that bottle. And we've got the glass right here. The only thing left to do is just play back some kind of an animation, because this is not really the desktop. This is just a video that Janik made, and we're gonna play that back. And as it plays, we're gonna pour in the orange juice. How cool is that? And now that I have a little bit of time together with the brand new LG Ultra Wide, I'd like to mention that this thing right here covers 98% of the DCI-P3 color space. It also covers 135% of the sRGB color space, and it has HDR600. So this thing right here is perfect for creative tasks such as video editing and color corrections. Now, what's also amazing about this Ultra Wide is that you have multiple inputs on the back, meaning that you can actually split the displays and have multiple monitors without having that bezel in the middle. Now, talking about awesome stuff, guys, check this out right here. We've got the brand new Aperture Nova P300C. This right here is an LED panel. We currently have the softbox modifier over it, but we can take that off. You can see now how super bright that thing is. Now, this is definitely one of the brightest LED panels that I've ever worked with before, but that's not even the coolest part about this. This right here is what I think the coolest thing. You can also control this light through an app. It is the software behind this LED panel what is so amazing. For instance, I can change this to tungsten light, or I can also put on one of the thousands of effects that this light has, such as a party. That's right, this thing right here is an RGB light, so anything is basically possible.
So, if I understand correctly, there is no post-production. And I'm not needed anymore.
Wait! We can do something in post-production. To make the effect next level, you can place something on the monitor that will give the intention there will be fluid coming from the monitor. So we used a clip of an orange on the LG monitor. I'm not going to go in detail, but I just animated a picture of an orange to pop up, then drop to the bottom of the screen while rolling to the corner where we will pour out the orange juice. And to give it something extra, I also shrank the orange and made it more brownish, because it's losing its liquid. And that's it for the first Zach King editing magic trick. Next up is stealing stuff throughout a computer screen. And thinking about that, what would you steal if you had the possibility to steal through a computer screen? I would steal a monitor. The new LG Ultra Wide monitor. Because, let's admit, who can resist that beautiful monitor? It works on the nano IPS technology, bringing the best of two worlds together. On one end, you get great color accuracy, which makes it perfect for every graphical task. And what that does is absorbing spill light to realize a richer and more accurate image. But at the same time, it's also great for gaming with their 144 refresh rate and 1 millisecond response time. And it's also NVIDIA G-Sync and AMD FreeSync compatible.
Ha, beautiful.
Okay, Janik, stop being so in love. Again, fire up Premiere Pro. Arr, mateys, let's have a look at the footage that we need. And this time we need two shots. Of course, on a tripod. One empty clean plate with our monitor and the glass of orange juice we are stealing, and one of the actor. But this shot needs something special. First, we made an outline stencil of the LG monitor, which we are going to use as a reference for our actor. So for the actor shot, we are going to remove the monitor and replace it with our stencil. Then let your actor sit behind the desk and the stencil. And now the actor can start grabbing the orange juice through the stencil. Once you have that, place the two clips in Premiere Pro. The empty clip must be on the bottom and the actor clip on top. The next step will be some masking. So select the actor clip and here we can create a mask around his arm. Because the stencil casts a shadow on the actor's arm, we have a reference for the mask. Now mask the arm out for the entire length of the clip, and once you grab the orange juice, you can include that in your mask. Oh yeah, if you don't want to do the brainless masking, you can always rotoscope your arm with the new roto brush from After Effects. You'll find a link with more information in the description below. Now, very important, we are going to cover up the glass of the orange juice from the empty shot, otherwise we are cloning and not stealing. And one last thing, add a displacement or a distort effect to your likings to the monitor. We used the prism displacement from Red Giant, but this can be any distort effect you want. And normally that will leave you with this. Super easy. The last effect, guys, which is actually pretty sad. However, it's going to be a cool one. We are going to crawl through a monitor from one scene to another. And with our new LG monitor, this is going to be a walk in the park. The 38-inch 21:9 aspect ratio at a quad HD resolution gives us a huge working field. So Jordy will have enough room to crawl through. But besides that, the monitor also gives enough room to multitask on, expanding your workspace. Which I really like while editing, because my timeline can never be big enough. For this effect, we are only going to explain the crawling out of the screen, as crawling in is exactly the same, but in reverse. Now let's fire up Premiere Pro for the last time. Again, we already have our footage ready, but let me show you what you need. First, we need an empty shot of the monitor from a tripod, and then the second shot is going to be a green screen shot from the same tripod. Once you have your empty shot, you can remove the monitor from the desk and make sure that the desk stays exactly in the same place. So we took a green screen stencil and placed it where the monitor was. This way your actor knows exactly where to crawl, then take out the green screen and place it behind the desk. Now last, place the table behind your desk so that the actor has something to crawl on. If needed, you can also place a green screen on top of that. And then, just take your shot. That's it. Now in Premiere Pro it's quite easy. Place your empty shot on the bottom layer and your green screen shot on top. Now just key out the green, draw a mask here and there, and bada bim bada boom, they match perfectly.
That's good. Cookies.
And now it's time for Genix Fun Fact Function! I recently found out that I'm older than Zai King. Exactly 1 month. But did you know that Zai King made videos right from the start? At age 7 he was already filming his sisters. But from age 14 he really got serious and bought himself a proper camera and a MacBook. Then 4 years later in 2008 he started his own website called FinalCutKing.com where he made tutorials for Final Cut. And from there on out he grew into the magical editor he is now. He is a real inspiration for us all. But that was it for this week guys, I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, thank you LG for the support and the super awesome ultra wide monitor. And as always, stay creative.
The sad part about Fridays is that we always need to clean up the studio after the shoot. Have you guys seen my cactus? Is it called cactus in English? I think so. This is a very special cactus. It's pretty tall and it's quite ugly. I have no idea why I keep this.